哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名正道。
哈利路亚 ，In name of the Lord Jesus, I speak。
主所亲爱的大家，晚上平安。
Dear brothers and sisters, peace be with you tonight。
靠着圣灵的帮助
，By the help of the Holy Spirit，
我们继续来分享但以理书第二章的信息。
We continue to share on the book of Daniel chapter 2。
这次我们继续看到。但以理书中世界的历史，世界的梦。
We continue examining on the dream of this world, the history of this world.
特别是帝国的兴起以及帝国的衰败跟灭亡。
Especially pertaining to the rise and prosperity of kingdoms and also their downfall.
那大家请注意，神借着这个世界的梦启示我们，这个世界是一个怎样的世界。
And take note that it is through this dream of this world, the Lord God revealed to us what this world truly is.
让我们神的儿女要看清楚，认识非常清楚的来认识这个世界。
And we as the children of God, we have to take this opportunity to truly know and get to learn about this world.
还没有解释这个梦之前，神就先启示这个世界有三种形象。它的三个形象是什么
？Before we explain and interpret these dreams, this dream already revealed to us what are these three images.
目的是透过这三个形象，让我们去认识它，去看清楚。
And through these three images, we are able to get to know clearly what this world truly is.
请看但以理书的二章三十一节。
We turn to the book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 31.
请念。
Verse 31. You, O king, were watching, and behold, a great image. This great image, whose splendor was excellent, stood before you, and its form was awesome.
看到吗？这在三十一节里面就直接启示这个世界有三大形象，它的形象。
This verse has a revealed to us this great image.
第一，这个世界呢是很高，它这个像呢，它的形象是非常高的，非常高的。
Firstly, this is a great image which is high and tall.
那么我们上次就已经讲介绍过了，那世界就是至高至大的，是非常骄傲的。
In the last session, we already described how this world was prideful and arrogant and haughty.
神启示我们，这个世界不会谦卑的，一定是非常骄傲的。
God revealed to us that this world would never be humble but arrogant.
而且一定要胜过神，人定胜天，一定要比神高，比神厉害。
And men want to be more superior than God, and they want their will to be higher than God's will.
如果只是发明了一些东西，只是发现了一些科学的东西，就非常了不起，非常的骄傲，非常的不认识神啊。
Through some very minor inventions or discoveries, and people get so haughty and arrogant, and they start to forget about God.
只不过是发现很早就存在的事实而已。
It is all about the discovery of something that existed long before.
所以神启示我们，这个世界是骄傲的。
Therefore, God revealed to us that this world is prideful.
我们不要再跟从这个世界的潮流，它是骄傲的。
Do not follow the trends of this world because it will lead you to pride.
那有一句话这样讲。
There's a saying.
嫉妒的人没有朋友。
Someone who is jealous will not have friends.
嫉妒的人真的是没有朋友的，他因为你胜过他，你高过他，你厉害过他，他就踩你的，他就贬低你的，他就对付你的，他怎么会有朋友呢
？Someone who is jealous and envious of others will never have friends because once they befriend you and they will always be jealous of you.
如果你不厉害过他，你差过他，你输给他，他又何必跟你做朋友呢？他都看不起你呀，你都高攀不上呀。所以嫉妒的人真的是没有朋友的。
And if this jealous person is greater than you or mightier than you, and they will not even befriend you.
那么愤怒的人呢是没有自己的。
And an angry person will not have himself.
一个人愤怒的时候，把自己也毁灭掉了。
Because
整个家庭、整个婚姻、整个所有的一切都毁灭掉，自己也毁灭掉了。
That is to say that an angry person would even sabotage or destroy himself, including along with his family.
这真的是很可怕的。
That is very frightening.
但更可怕的是什么呢
？What is even more frightening？
骄傲的人没有神啊。
A haughty person, a proud person will not have God.
希望大家记得这句话。
Please remember this saying.
嫉妒的人没有朋友。
A jealous man will not have friends.
愤怒的人没有自己。
An angry man will not have himself.
骄傲的人没有真神，没有神。
A proud man will not have God.
你知道为什么没有神吗
？Do you know why he has not?
因为他自己都不需要神啊。
Why he does not have God? Because he does not need God.
个人骄傲的时候，他自己就是神啊，他何必还要敬拜神啊？他何必还要遵守神的吩咐呀
？When one is proud and he himself already reckons himself as God.
当他骄傲的时候，连神都被他看不起，都被他藐视了。神在他心里算什么？神到底算什么呀？
And when he is proud, he will even look down on God and despise God.
所以你要看清楚什么叫做骄傲。
Therefore, clarify yourself what pride is.
骄傲不只是哇，是炫耀啊，我很有才干啊，哇，我很有钱啊，那个是很肤浅的骄傲啊，很肤浅的那种骄傲。
Pride is not just about being very talented and being very wealthy than others.
可怕的，真正骄傲的最可怕的就是没有神。
But the worst kind of pride, the most frightening is that you have no God.
连神都要听他，连神都在他的脚下，都在他下面，他都高过神的呀。
And God should listen to this person, and he tramples God below his feet.
我今天为什么讲这个
？Why am I talking about this?
就是神启示我们，这个世界就是这样骄傲的，自高自大。
That's by the revelation of God that this world is prideful and haughty.
所以你说这个世界会敬拜神吗？
Therefore,
会遵守神的话吗
？Do you think that this world will eventually worship God and observe His word?
这是世界的第一个形象。
That's the first image of this world.
第二个形象是什么呢
？What's the second image?
这里说他极其光耀，非常的外表，非常亮丽，非常。
It's described here whose splendor was excellent.
这些都是外表而已。
This was all in outer appearance.
你看这个世界真的是很漂亮啊，很繁华。
You look around in this world, it is indeed full of splendor.
啊，那你要清楚，你就看启示录那个大淫妇，她的外表多么光鲜亮丽啊。
If you want to learn more, you can look at the prostitute in the book of Revelation with all this beautiful outlook.
她的外表、她的衣着、她的首饰、她所穿戴的，全部都是金光闪闪，都是珠光宝气啊，都是非常高贵、非常有价值的。
Her appearance, her clothes, and which are all adorned with the most precious things, and also very highly full of splendor.
启示录启示我们说，地上的君王，连君王都被她的外表迷倒了。那些臣宰、那些将军啊，那些长。宰相啊，那些智慧人啊，哦，那些百姓啊，生意人，全部被他的美色外表迷倒了。迷醉了。
The book of Revelation describes to us that even the kings and also the officials, and as well as the wise men and the people of the kingdoms have been seduced by her beauty.
这说明什么呢
？What does that describe?
世界的外表极其是荣耀美丽的，真的是这样。
That the outer appearance of this world appears to be full of splendor.
神启示我们不要被他的外表这种外表的这种华丽哈迷惑，绝对不，千万不要。
And God has revealed to us that we do not fall into this seduction.
但它里面却是哈邪灵啊，是恶魔来的，是丑陋的，是污秽的。
Because behind this beauty is but unclean spirit and filthiness.
我们信徒，我们基督徒要清楚这一点哦。
Therefore, we members, Christians, have to understand this.
好，第三个形象是什么呢
？What's the third image?
第三个形象，世界的形象是形状甚是可怕，非常可怕。
Its form was awesome.
那我们读到第七章的时候，我们才来解释它的形象哈。
We'll talk about its form when it comes to chapter 7.
因为第七章有很清楚的把它的好可怕的形象哦描述出来。
Chapter 7 has a very clear and detailed description of its form.
那就是很可怕的怪兽啊，很可怕的怪兽，很凶恶的怪兽。
It is a very ferocious and dreadful monster.
那么启示录也说，这个世界呢成了鬼魔的住处，它的可怕也在这里。
And the book of Revelation also revealed to us that this world has become its habitation.
这是神启示我们这个世界的三大形象是这样的。
And these are the three forms or images of this image.
那还有它有四个不正常的地方，不正常的地方。
There are four abnormal images.
什么事情上不正常呢
？What are these abnormal things?
它的重量哦，这个世界的重量是不正常的，是那是不稳固的。
That is the weight of this image was not normal.
为什么我们这样讲呢
？Why am I saying this?
你看它的头是重的，最重的是头，但是脚呢是最。
You can see that the image's head was the heaviest, and the its legs was lightest.
看三十二节
，verse 32。
这像的头是金的，胸膛膀臂是银的，肚腹和腰是铜的，腿是铁的，脚是半铁半泥的，对不对？你看它在这么多矿物质当中啊。
In all these minerals,
金子是所有矿物质中最重最重的就是金子，重量最重的就是金子。
Among these elements, and this gold is the of the highest weight, greatest weight.
那么一直下来的到最，它的脚那边都是铁跟泥土来的，泥土很快就碎的，很快就松散掉的。
Coming down to its feet, which is a very fragile and a very very brittle because it's made of clay.
那神要启示我们什么？
What is God trying to reveal?
神启示我们这个世界是不稳固的呀。
That's to reveal to us that this world is unstable.
它是头重脚轻，随时都会整个世界会倒下来，都会倒下来的。
Its head is heavy, its feet is light, and it will fall and collapse anytime.
哦，我们做建筑的人，读建筑的人就知道了哈，读工程系的人就知道。
If you are in the industry of construction, you will know this.
无论你起多高楼，几百层楼多高楼，你下面的地基一定是重。过上面的一定是稳固过上面的。
Regardless of how high your building is,、嗯、your foundation has to be the heaviest.、
啊、我们说是三角形嘛、哦、
It has to be take the form of a triangle.、嗯、
但是这个世界呢，神启示我们说它是相反的，头是最重的，但是脚呢 ，foundation 呢是最轻的，甚至是泥土来的。
But God revealed to us that this world is upside down, and in fact, the head is heaviest, and the feet are lightest.
所以你还要把你的所有的生命都投资在这个世界吗
？So do you still want to invest all your life into this world?
你要把你的钱财、所有的儿女的家庭全部投资在这世界吗
？Are you about to invest all your money and all your family into this world?
或者你一时哈得从里面得到好处啊，得到荣耀。
For the temporary, you know, interest and benefits and glory.
所谓的荣耀就是从世界来的那种荣耀了。
When I say glory, it means this worldly glory.
但神启示我们这不稳固啊，这是不长久，随时会倒。
But God has already revealed to us that it will collapse on top of any time.
这叫做重量上哈不正常，非常不正常。
That's when it is abnormal in the sense that of its weight.
这你必须要知道。
And you have to know this.
好，那第二个不正常是什么呢
？What's the second abnormal?
就是它的价值呢是越来越低的。
Its value reduces.
哦，这个叫做价值上的不正常。
That's an abnormality.
你看，金子是最贵重的，最贵重的是头是金子。
Now you see the gold is of the highest value.
那一直下来呢，就是银啊，价值一开始下了。
And trickle down to silver.
那银再下来就是铜，那个价值更低了。
And trickle down to bronze, which is of a lower value.
铜已经够价值已经够低了，那下来的腿是铁的，那铁的价值又更低了。
And its legs are made of iron, which is of a lower value.
你说铁的价值低，再下来更糟糕啊，是泥土来的呀，泥土更没有价值呀。
And then further down, it is only made of soil and clay, which is of no value.
这个叫做在价值上的不正常。
And that's the abnormality in terms of its value.
这世界是越来越没有价值啊。
This world will get less and less value.
不是说越来越有价值，是越来越没有价值啊。
It will not grow in terms of its value.
这神启示我们，这是他第二个不正常的地方。
That's the revelation of God in terms of its abnormality.
所以你还这么爱这个世界吗
？Do you still love this world then?
看清楚了没有呢
？Have you seen clearly?
第三个不正常在哪里
？What's the third abnormality?
在硬度上，它的硬度上不正常，硬。
In terms of its hardness.
嗯，它是越来越硬的，看到吗
？Take note that it is harder and harder.
注意看哦。铁比铜更硬，对不对？铁比铜是更硬的。
We know that iron is harder than bronze.
但是铜呢，比银又更加硬的。
But bronze is harder than silver.
但是银呢，又比金更硬的。
Silver is harder than gold.
它是越来越硬。
It is harder and harder.
人的心越来越硬。
The hearts of men are harder than harder.
嗯。到最后呢，到他的脚的时候呢，却突然间是软的。
And when it finally comes to the feet, it became soft.
因为泥土是软的。
Because the clay is soft.
啊，软它泥土跟铁哦，铁是最硬，比金子更硬，比铜更硬，比金更硬，比银更硬。可是呢，哦，铁跟泥土一个是硬的，一个是软的，两个合在一起，最硬的跟最软的合在一起。
Now that iron is the hardest element among all these elements, and yet it has been placed together and mixed together with the softest clay.
有软有硬啦，有最硬的也在里面，有最软的也在里面。
That's the part where there are the hard parts and there are also the soft parts in the same.
这个叫做在硬度上的不正常。
That's the abnormality in terms of its hardness.
你知道这是什么意思吗
？Do you know what that means?
世界的心很硬，世界的心也很软。
That's
什么意思呢
？The heart of this world is hard, and at the same time, it is also soft.
如果对神的心哦，当讲到神的时候，敬拜真神，哦，要服从真神，顺从真神的时候，我们的心就很硬了。
Whenever,
我们的心非常硬，听不下去这种道理，
whenever,
听不下去。
One hears about the word of God and the matters regarding to God's kingdom, and his heart becomes hardened, and he will no longer be able to bear.
很大的理由。
And he will justify a lot.
我们有自由。
He has his freedom.
你不能够强迫我。
You can't force me.
我有自由选择要敬拜神还是不要来聚会。 我有自由。
I have my human rights and my freedom of choices.
那个这样的说法就说明你的心很硬。对神的时候，你的心很硬啊， 没得看。 没得商量，也没得劝勉，你完全拒绝劝勉。
That goes to say that whenever it comes to matters regarding God, you will not negotiate and you will not talk about it, or if you reject it all.
懂不懂？讲说我们有人权，我们有自由，这是我们的人权，这是我们的自由。
You talk about human rights and you talk about freedom of religion and everything.
这些人权自由还大过神的。
And all this of freedom and human rights are greater than God.
你抬出人权，抬出自由来，神都要靠边站的。 把神放在另一边的，连神都不存在了。
When you talk about freedom of rights and human rights, even God has to step aside.
这时候说明什么？
What does that tell you?
这时候说明的心对神是非常硬的，好像越来越硬，非常的坚硬。
The man's heart towards God is harder and harder.
那你的心什么时候会软下来呢？
When will your heart be softened?
太简单了。
Very simple.
你对这个世界的时候呢，对这个荣华富贵呢，对这些财宝呢，你的心很软的。
You look at the splendor and the luxury of this world, your heart becomes so soft.
世界只向你照来呀，来呀，你的心就跟着去了，你的心就不会拒绝的了，你的心就不会跟他抵挡的了，你的心就是跟着他去的了，不是这样吗？
The world simply has to gently whisper to you, come over here, and you will completely accept.
所以我们读到这里的时候，我们发现到这个信仰上这个很可怕的一件事情，一件事。
Now when we read this part, we realize something very frightening in our life of faith.
铁跟泥是掺在一起的。That
iron is mixed with clay.
铁是所有金属中是最硬的。And
this iron is the hardest element of all.
在这里的金银铜铁啦，它是最硬的。Among
these elements mentioned here, it is the hardest.
可是泥土是最软的。But
clay is the softest.
怎么会这样子？
How is that possible?
原来这个就是世界人的心。That
is the heart of man.
对神真的很硬，越来越硬。
And that the heart of man becomes harder and harder towards.
对世界是非常软，越来越软。And
yet, towards this world, it becomes softer and softer.
你没有发现到这样吗？
Didn't you notice that?
我甚至我们信徒，我们真耶稣教会的信徒的信仰状况也是这样呀。That
goes the same for the faith in True Jesus Church.
听到道理很难接受啊，越来越难接受，不是这样子吗？
And people can find the sermons harder and harder to accept.
以前我们小的时候，那个时代哈，道理很硬，常常被责备，我们都接受的，我们还感动天嘛，我们还说感谢神啊，今天被直视骂，被主耶稣责备啊，心里很高兴啊，哭啊。 但是心里是高兴的呀。In
the old days, and when we hear of these harsh sermons, and we get so moved and touched, and we even tear up.
因为道理把我们的污秽讲出来，把我们的骄傲讲出来，把我们的贪心，把我们各种的污秽全部都清除掉呀。Because
the sermon is able to cleanse us and burn us of our sins away.
那我们为什么当时会接受这种道理？
And how is it that we were able to accept? Because our hearts were soft.
接受从天上来的雨水，我们就吸收那天上的雨水呀，那个生命的水呀。
We are able to accept the rains, the showers of blessing from heaven.
那今天你试试看今天的信徒。
But you try today.
你知道多少人对传道反感，你知道吗？
Do you know how many are unhappy with me?
坐在这里的我不知道，一直在看着我，但是有没有反感我，我不知道。
I'm not sure with all you seated here, you're looking at me nicely.
就许多对我很好的，但背地里都一直说我的坏话，我知道呀。
There are also those who are nice to me in front of me, but talk bad about.
那传道到底做错了什么事情？
But what have I done wrong?
让信徒这么讨厌。
That the members would hate me.
讲来讲去就是在讲道理骂人，就是这样。
That's just because of my harsh sermon.
那个说明我们的心已经硬了。 越来越硬了。That
simply tells us that our hearts become harder.
我不能够接受这种道理，不能够接受这个传道。I
cannot accept this kind of sermon, this preacher.
虽然他是要洁净我，虽然是要我们的灵魂得救，虽然是要我们敬畏神。Although
his intention is to purify us, to cleanse us, and to save us.
是不是你对神的心、对道理、对真理是不是很硬？你自己讲啊。Isn't
it true that your heart towards the sermon of God?
请问你对世界会有这样的硬心吗？会这样的拒绝？会这样的反感吗？对世界？
It's hardened, and would you be so hard-hearted towards the matters of this world?
他只是招一招手，只是讲几句好听的话，你都跟着去了，你的心都融掉了，融在他里面了。
The world just have to wave at you and sweet talk a few words, and your heart will be melted.
这就是铁跟泥，一个硬一个软的。 真实的事件。
And this is the truth about mixing the clay and the iron.
这叫做第三个不正常，硬度上的不正常。
That's a third abnormality in terms of its hardness.
第四个不正常是哪里呢
？What's the fourth abnormality?
这个世界的第四个不正常就是混杂的不正常，混杂的非常不正常。
The abnormality of confusion.
铁跟泥掺在一起嘛，
That clay and iron have been mixed together.
就是混杂了。
It's been confused.
我们来看但以理书二章。
We look at chapter 2.
我们读四十三节。
Verse 43.
来，请念。
Verse 43. As you saw iron mixed with ceramic clay, they will mingle with the seed of man, but they will not adhere to one another, just as iron does not mix with clay.
对吗？你看见铁跟泥掺杂，那么那国民呢？世界的国民呢？也必与各种族的人掺杂。
And this, the men of these kingdoms of this world will also be mixed together.
世界啊，这人种啊，民族啊，国家啊，都已经掺杂了，大家都已经掺在一起了。
That's when the seed of man have been mixed together.
但是呢，虽然是掺在一起，但是呢，他们是不能够相合的，不能够真正同心合意的，不能够的，不能相合的。
And, although they mingle with each other, but they are unable to adhere to each other.
虽然掺在一起，正如铁跟泥不能够相合，不能铁跟泥不能粘在一起的。
They are mixed together, but they are likened to iron and clay, unable to really mix.
这个是个大混杂的时代，所以神启示我们这个世界。末世这个世界更是一个混杂的时代，它都没有纯度的，
Lord,
没有纯洁的。
The Lord God has revealed to us that this world is but a world of great irony and confusion.
因此，这种混杂的不正常造成了可怕的灰色地带。
This abnormal part of this world has been confusion. There's a huge gray area.
灰色地带，灰色哦，听说灰色是用白跟黑混杂。黑跟白的颜色掺杂而产生出来的 第三种颜色就是灰色。
When you mix a white with black, it will produce a color gray.
就像看第一章的第二节这样。
Just like looking at chapter 1 verse 2.
你看神分别为圣的器皿哦，连普通的祭司、普通的利未人都不能够进去随便动的，分别为圣的器皿。
That all these sacred articles which have been consecrated for holy use, even the Levites of the lower of the average rank cannot approach it.
啊，你要被指定的人才可以进去处理的。
Only the specific ones were allowed to approach.
那就是说，它非常严谨的分别的，不是所有的人都可以进去，不是每一个利未人都可以去动。分别出来的非常圣洁。
This is by a very strict measures that this has been consecrated for holy use.
但是你看到一章二节的时候是什么
？But when you look at chapter 1 verse 2,
这么神圣圣洁的神的器皿，哪还有分别出来？它都跟偶像的庙、跟偶像的东西掺杂在一起，放在一起，就是掺杂在一起了。
Now where do you see that these holy articles have been consecrated? It has been mixed together with the items of the idols.
这个是巴比伦王做的事啊，这个是世界做的事情啊，不是神做的事情啊。
These are the things performed by King Nebuchadnezzar and things of this world.
把神的那种圣洁的、哦、独一的、荣耀的掺杂在偶像假神里面去，真真假假掺在一起，里面有真诚的器皿，也有偶像的器皿，是真是假都掺在一起，有真有假，有圣洁有污秽，都掺在一起。
And now what is glorious and holy and sacred of God have been mixed together with what is filthy and unclean on this world.
就是你看但以理书看到的一个很严重的问题。
And that's a very great issue that we see in the book of Daniel.
这些掺杂，传道称它为灰色地带。
And all this confusion, I call this a gray zone.
你说它有黑的时候，它又有白。
When you say that it's all black, it has also got white in it.
你说它白的时候，它事实上它有黑在里面。
And when you call it white, it is also black.
我们真耶稣教会的信徒要注意这个问题哦，灰色地带。
Therefore, members of the True Jesus Church should take note of the gray area.
今天在性别上的困惑。性别，男跟女、哦、已经混杂在一起。
Today the confusion of gender。
圣经告诉我们，男就是男，女就是女，男有男的衣装，女有女的服装，都很清楚的，都很容易分别的，一看就知道的。
Well, the Bible has already set a very clear line and distinction between men and women and what they wear and what they do.
现在这个世界，男跟女的衣服还有分别吗？ 你也不知道这是男穿的还是女穿的，那共同穿都可以的。
But in our contemporary world, can we even tell the difference really? Because the clothes are unisex already.
啊，你在后面看长头发的，你以为是漂亮的女孩，你到前面一看，哇，吓死你啊！男人来的呀。
You see someone with long hair, with long silky, smooth hair, you come to the front and you are shocked because he's a man.
因为性别已经混合了，分不清不男不女了，现在。
Because now gender has been confused and you can't even tell who is man and who is woman.
神创造的原则就是分各从其类，没有混杂的。请注意创世纪的神的创造，没有混杂的，非常各从其类的。
Now the principle of God's creation is very, it has a very clear line of distinction and all to its kind, and there's no confusion.
但是人就是要反抗神，就要厉害过神。我们不用分得这么清楚，我们可以男也可以是女，女也可以是男，我们可以不男不女都可以。那为什么一定男是男，女是女呢？不需要这样。
A man prides itself.Price himself to become greater than God and set the standards to say that we can be also both.
那这个是性别上的困难。
That's a confusion in terms of gender.
已经都是这样子，世界潮流都已经这样子了。
This is also the trends of this world already.
那么在宗教上的困难。
There's also the confusion of religions.
啊，我们世界五大宗教已经合为一，把它所谓的合一就是五大宗教全部混杂在一起合为一了。
And there's also been a union of all five major religions of this world.
大家都知道哦，十字架一定是主耶稣基督的，不可能是释迦牟尼的。十字架一定是耶稣基督的。
When you see a symbol of a cross, it has to be Jesus. It cannot be the Buddha.
那么那个莲花坐在莲花上的那个佛祖，那个莲花哦，那一定是佛祖啊，他们的佛教的那个佛祖呀。
But when you see the symbol of the lily, it has to be the symbol of Buddha.
但是他们现在告诉你不一定是这样喽。
But today people tell you it is not so anymore.
那种讲法是过时了。
You are outdated.
那种讲法也不合乎世界潮流，是合乎世界人的心啊，世界人的那种要求啊。
When you say that, it is no longer in line with the requirements of this world.
那现在是怎么样讲的呢？
What do people say today?
你看到钉在十字架上的不一定是耶稣，那可能也可以是释迦牟尼。
You see someone kneeled on a cross, it may not be Jesus, it could be Buddha.
不一定是主耶稣来的。
It may not be Jesus.
那现在坐在莲花上的也可能是主耶稣基督啊，不一定是佛祖啊。
And the one seated.
主耶稣也可以坐在莲花上面的，为什么不可以啊？
They were seated on the great lotus, may not be Buddha, but it could also be Jesus.
十几年前，这个五大宗教的那个领袖，最高领袖，哦，成了一个联合公布一个声明，五教合一，没有分彼此，都困杂，没有分你是基督教啊，我是佛教啊，你是真神啊，我是什么，都一样。
A decade or more ago, certain religious leader of this World Religion Committee have actually announced that to have a union of all religions.
你信哪一个宗教都可以得救的。
That you can believe in any religion to be saved.
那为什么一定要信耶稣啊？因为信其他宗教也可以得救的呀。
Why do you have to believe in Jesus? You can be saved from other religions.
那主耶稣何必道成肉身呢？因为信其他宗教也可以得救，他何必死在十字架上啊？那不是神经病吗？
Then why would
你为什么这样钉死在世界这么傻？因为我信其他宗教，我也可以进天国的呀。你为什么这么笨啊？这么傻呀？死在十字架上。
Why was Jesus so foolish to have to come all the way in the form of flesh to be nailed on the cross to establish the salvation plan for man?
那基督教耶稣这样钉死十字架，不是变成愚拙吗？圣经说的成了愚拙的道理。愚拙的这种方法，得救的方法是很愚蠢的方法。
If that were the case, and just like what the Bible described, that it was the most foolish acts of all, that he has to do all this in order to salvation.
这种神救人的得救进天国的这种方法，在圣经里面就已经被人家讥笑了。在新约，你看，人家说这个十字架道理是愚拙的啦。
And this
is 愚蠢道理来的啦。
This were indeed deemed by many people in the Bible as a foolish act.
这是。宗教上的困惑了。
This is the confusion in terms of religion.
还有很多困惑了，事物上的困惑啊。
There are also religion in food.
还有那些植物啊，种植物的困惑啊，这个树掺什么啊，这个果子掺什么果子，掺，全部都困惑啊。
And also a confusion in planting, a lot of hybrids of breeds and species.
这是一个大混杂的时代。
This is a world of great irony and confusion.
难道叫它做灰色地带？
That I call the gray area.
那它意思是什么，知道吗？
What does that mean?
原来灰色地带就是没有黑，也没有所谓的黑，也没有所谓的白，没有所谓的真，也没有所谓的假。它的重点在这里。
This gray area has nothing truly black, nothing truly white, nothing truly true, nothing truly false.
那么真耶稣教会就是一直强调真神的呀，真理的呀。
What a truth is
真有假的，真耶稣就是传这种道理的呀。
Stresses on that one true God and also on the truth and also falsehood.
那圣经也一直在强调哈、哦，真神啊，敬拜真神有哈、哦、不要拜啊有假神啊。
The Bible
真有假呀。
Stresses to us that there are true God, there is a true God and false God.
那连其他的基督教派都已经放弃了，都已经不强调这个了。
Even other Christian denominations have given up on this thing.
那我们真耶稣教会，请问我们真耶稣教会今天还在坚持坚持？你说会有市场吗？会得人心吗？你自己想呀。
And you say that if the True Jesus Church continue to insist on this truth,
传道一直在台上这样坚持独一真教会，你听得下去吗？你现在听得下去？我问你，过几年你听得下去吗？
Would people be happy to accept this truth? And even you say that you are able to accept it now, would you still accept it a few more years to come?
我一定是听得进去的，我从小就听独一真教会了。
You say that preacher, of course I can because I started from young.
你不要太大意了。
Do not be too confident.
你不要好像彼得说，我不会出卖你的，就算跟你死也是可以的，就算跟你下贱老主啊，我也不会出卖你的。他就出卖主了。刚刚讲不会，他就出卖主。
Peter,
难道 你不会像彼得这样吗？你以为你不会吗？
Peter just said that he would go to the prison and go into death with Jesus Christ, and he then denied Jesus.
那我今天这样讲这件事情，因为几年前有个 信徒也是跟我这样讲不会的，可是几年后他说传道，你不要再讲独一真教会，他已经变了，他已经不能接受独一真教会了。
I'm able to tell you a true case about a member telling me that he would accept this truth about the one true church, but a few years later he stopped me from preaching about that.
因为他已经进入到灰色地带了，没有真，没有假，没有黑，没有白了，没有了。
Yes, yes.
都一样的，都一样的。
Entered into the gray area where there is nothing completely true, nothing completely false.
灰色地带是魔鬼工作的地方。
The gray area is where the devil works.
一般上我们说、啊、魔鬼工作的地方是黑嘛，黑的地方就是魔鬼的地方嘛。
We usually say that this is the black area where the devil works.
那么白色的地方就是圣洁嘛，就是神的儿女的地方，神的地方嘛。
And the white area would be where holiness and sacredness is.
结果怎么样呢？
What is now?
白的那个黑的不能够去。
Now,
白的地方黑的不能够去。
Those from the black cannot go over to the white.
为什么？因为黑一进到白那边就很清楚黑的，因为里面全部白的呀。你一个是黑的就很清楚，一看就是黑的，所以各个不入，各个不入。
If someone is in black and he goes into the area of white, he will be very outstanding, and people will recognize he's a black.
教会是白的，是圣洁的，所以魔鬼是黑的，是为了要进圣洁的白的这个地方来，一下就看得出。
Now,
一下就分辨出来，所以他不能够怎样工作，他做不到。
The church shines in the radiance of white and holiness, and when the blackness of the devil comes in, he cannot work.
那么如果黑的地方，那是他自己的地方，有什么好做工呢？他本来就是那些地方，就是那些人都跟从他的，他也不需要怎么做工，因为那本来就是他的地方。
But if the devil is continues to stay in the black area and is already his own kingdom and he has no work to do,
那你话真的吗？黑的是他地方，不用怎么样做工；白的他又进不了去做工，因为太明显。
Now, do you realize that in his own black area, he doesn't have any work to do, but he cannot enter into the white area?
结果他就发明了，他就搞出一个不黑不白的中间地带，叫做灰色地带。有白有黑掺在一起，黑白的中间就是灰色地带，他就可以在那边工作，不断的工作。
And subsequently, the devil has to create a gray area where the white and the black have been mixed together, intertwined together, where he is able to perform his work.
传道的意思说，今天魔鬼最大的工作，而且不被人家发现到的，那就是灰色地带。
I'm trying to tell you that the best place for the devil to work without having others notice it would be the gray area.
小心啊，你的生活、你的人生、你的信仰，千万不要有灰色地带。
Please be careful.
白就是白，黑就是黑，对就对，错就错。你千万不要再多讲、再多解释。
In your life on earth, you have to really tell between what is black and white. There's no gray area.
那个约伯记哦，有一个灵界异象给我们看到。
And the book of Job tells us of a spiritual vision.
神问那个魔鬼：“你从哪里来？”
God questioned the devil, where do you come from?
难道神不知道魔鬼从哪里来吗？
Does God not know where the devil came from?
那既然知道，为什么还要问他呀？
If God already knew, then why would he ask?
神问魔鬼，魔鬼回答他从哪里来，是要跟让我们知道，是要告诉我们魔鬼在哪里工作。魔鬼的工作在什么地方？那重点在这里。
God asked the devil, where did he come from? It is for us to know.
那请问？神问魔鬼你从哪里来，请问魔鬼怎么回答神啊？请问
Let me ask you, when God asked the devil, where did you come from? How did the devil answer?
那些神学班的
Those of you who studied theology before
他说什么，他从哪里来？
What did the devil say? Where did you come from?
他从地上往返而来，走来走去，去了又回来，回来又去，就是走来走去，从地上走来走去。
The devil said that from going to and fro on the earth.
魔鬼说他就是从那个地方来的。
And the devil said that he came from there.
而且他在那边工作的呀。
He works from there.
走来走去就是他的工作范围啊，他的工作场所呀。
Going to and fro, his place of work.
魔鬼走来走去还做什么？当然是做魔鬼工啦。走来走去还有好事的咩？
What other work would he do? It is the work of the devil.
他这么勤劳走来，每天走来走去，早上走来走去，晚上走来走去，你以为他在做什么？他当然是在做魔鬼工作，要寻找吞吃的人啊。
He's walking back and forth, going to and fro the earth, and what else would he be doing other than the work of devouring people?
我从地上往返而来，那个地上是什么？什么地方？就是灰色地带。
Walking back and forth on the earth, and this earth refers to the gray area.
就是今天世界告诉我们的，没有黑，没有白的。
That's what this world is telling you. There's a gray zone, nothing too black and white.
就算有，也不要太强调黑，也不要太强调白，大家都一样的。
You must not highlight and stress on the differences. We are all the same.
这个在但以理书，神就已经启示我们了。这是一个大混杂的时代，混杂的，没对没，没是没非的，没黑没白的，已经掺杂了的。
The book of Daniel already reveals to us by the Lord God that this world is but mixed with confusion.
这样明白了吗？
You understand now?
今天我们看到这个神启示我们，透过这个世界的梦启示我们，告诉我们这世界是一个怎样的世界。
This is the Lord God's revelation about this world through this dream of the world.
那我们继续看下去。
We continue reading.
他的头是金的哈。
His head in is gold.
胸是银的。
His chest and arms are of silver.
胸跟膀臂哈。肚腹是和腰是铜的。
His belly and thighs of bronze.
铁腿是铁的。
His legs of iron.
这什么意思呢？
What does that all mean?
这在代表什么？
What is the all symbolize?
那就要看但以理的解释了。
We look at how Daniel explained it.
但以理的解释就要从36节开始读了。
Verse 36 onwards.
一直到这个43节。
Until verse 43.
那我们剩下10分钟，还要怎么讲呢？
10 minutes to go. Are we able to finish this?
还是留给下次讲。
Shall we keep it for the next time?
我本来以为可以讲完这个世界的这种兴旺跟灭亡。
I thought I was able to finish the part about prosperity and the downfall of the world.
传道为了让大家认识这个世界，神启示的这世界有点啰嗦，讲长了一点。
But I've been too naggy about the part where I wanted you to understand the true image of this world.
没关系啦，慢一点无所谓啦。
It's okay, we can take our time.
最重要，我们真正的看清楚这个世界，不要被它欺骗，不要被它迷惑。
It is more important that we have a clear idea about this world of its deception.
这样我们拜六四点半继续这个世界的历史了，第三段是第三堂世界的历史。
We continue on the third session about this history of this world from on Saturday 4:30 p.m.
虽然它是世界的历史，但是也是蛮精彩的。
Although it's only about world history, but it is very interesting.
里面有很多精彩的故事的。
There are a lot of very interesting stories.
那有一些故事都跟圣经有关系的，好像波斯帝国啊，巴比伦帝国呀，好像希腊帝国，全部都跟圣经有关系，跟显明有关系的。
Some of this world history about the kingdoms of Babylon, Persia, and also other kingdoms, Greece, it is also related to the Bible.
那最后我们才讲永恒的国度。
And we will talk about the eternal kingdom eventually.
所以我们第一章用三堂来讲分享第一章。
We will take three sessions to talk about chapter one.
第二章可能要用五堂哦。
Chapter two, we may need five sessions.
大家不用急了哦，学习道理慢慢来，不用急啊。
Please, there's no need to rush. We will learn about this slowly.
就是最多是说传道太啰嗦了。
You will at most say that the preacher has been so naggy.
我们来唱诗。
Let's sing him.
唱诗379首。
We sing him 379.
转眼仰望耶稣。
Turn your eyes upon Jesus.
我们今天就以370集，转眼仰望耶稣作为我们这一堂信息的结论。
We'll take this theme 379, turn your eyes upon Jesus as a conclusion of this sermon.
无论这个世界怎么样的在变化，
regardless of how turbulent this world will change,
无论这世界怎么样说到它几骄傲几厉害，
and how prideful and arrogant the world is,
无论这个世界怎么样，大家怎么样合作的来抵挡神，说没有真神，没有假神，大家都一样的，没有真没有假的。无论不管他们讲什么。
And regardless of how the world merges together, combine forces to resist the true God about its truth and doctrine.
这首诗歌告诉勉励我们，转眼仰望耶稣，眼睛盯着主耶稣，不要看其他的，不要看左右。
This hymn encourages us, telling us to turn our eyes upon Jesus and not to our right, not to our left.
眼睛盯着主耶稣，看着主。
That we fix our eyes upon Jesus.
不要看这个世界。
Not to gaze on this world.
不要看这个风浪。
Not to look at the turbulence of this world.
不要看什么宗教、什么人、什么传道、什么长老讲什么，都不用看这些。
Not to even look at the world religions about how the preachers are talking and preaching.
你怎么知道传道不会改变呢？
And wouldn't you, how would you know that the preacher will remain the same?
已经变质了，你怎么知道呀？
How would you even know when a certain elder or a preacher has already deteriorated?
管他们变到怎样，我们就定睛在主耶稣的生命上。
Regardless of these people, how these people and how this world will change, we will fix our eyes on Jesus.
活在主耶稣荣耀的真理光中。
Believe in the glory of the truth of the Lord God.
真的，世上的东西，他们讲的，他们追求的，一切在我们的心里，这些都是虚空。
And in,
都是虚空。
Among all the pursuits and all the aspirations and ideals of this world, all are but vanity.
这是今天的总论。
This is the conclusion of today's sermon.
神借着世界的梦告诉我们，世界是这样。
It is through this dream of this world, the Lord God tells us that this is how the world looks like.
魔鬼已经制造了一个很大的灰色地带，就在灰色地带工作。
The devil has already created a huge gray area where it will work.
这个灰色地带也可以进入到真教会、真耶稣教会里面去。
And this gray area will also be brought into the church.
这个灰色地带也可以进入到每一个人我们的内心里面去，有一个灰色地带。
This gray area will also seep into the hearts of us.
你一有灰色地带，撒旦就进去工作，肯定的。
As soon as you have the gray area in your heart, the devil will work in you.
因为神已经告诉我们了，借着问魔鬼你从哪里来，魔鬼已经回答了，我就是从那个地方来的。
The Lord God already questioned the devil, "Where do you come from?" The devil has already answered that he came from there.
还记得传道讲的见证吗？
Do you remember my testimony?
有信徒说我不会反对。我不会赞成这个同性恋，我不赞成。
A certain member told me that I would not agree with homosexuality.
但是我也不会反对他们。
But I will also not deny.
我不赞成同性恋，但是我也不反对他们。请问这是什么？这就是灰色啊。
When I say,
到底是对的还是错的？你不赞成，但是你也不会反对，那怎么样？这就是灰色。
When you say that you don't agree, you also don't disagree, and that is a gray area.
就你明明说你赞成，那我们还很清楚啊，你是赞成的。
If you're able to,
可是他又说我不赞成。
Have a clear stand and clear statement about whether you agree or not. We are very clarified with that.
可是你说他不赞成的时候，他说我也不会反对，那到底怎么样呀？
But when you say that he doesn't agree, he also doesn't deny. And what does that actually mean?
传道要讲的就是今天讲的灰色地带。
This is the gray area that the preacher is trying to tell you.
混杂。
It's confusion.